Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3 with your host ShadowFury333, and we are back in Firelink Shrine because I have not changed anything, although I mentioned last time that there were some framerate issues. I think I've addressed them. Hopefully it won't affect the video quality too much, but at least it'll be much smoother. So, let's explore around this place, because this is kind of both new and old. And hey, there's the Maiden in Black, slash Emerald Herald, slash... she's more of a Maiden in Black, honestly. So hey, it's the Maiden in Black. Alright. And up here is... a hallway with messages. Okay, so the bonfire goes to Lothric, which, as you heard in the intro, was a place to go. It sounded like a really happening place. In as much as a world populated almost entirely by undead can have a happening place. But hey, by those standards, it sounded like a positive party destination. And down here there's fire and death? Catacombs? Everyone's favorite Cornish blacksmith, Andre!
Well, a newcomer, I see.
Andre!
Andre, I serve at this shrine as a humble smith forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust?
I guess, sure. Why not?
Some journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms.
Well, I've got two.
Let me smith your weapons.
Oh.
I am a smith. Such is my purpose.
I'm sorry, I'm a cleric. Intelligence is my dump stat. Anyway, so yeah. Andre. From Dark Souls 1. I hope they only do this once. I mean, I don't mean to be a spoil sport because Andre is one of my favorite characters in Dark Souls 1. In my playthrough with Katrina Para, which was the Dark Souls 1 version of this character, I actually got to Undead Parish, and I was running for Andre, yelling, Andre! The whole time, because I knew he was there, the second playthrough, obviously, not the first one, and was really happy to see Andre, because of course it meant weapon upgrades. Now, I could reinforce weapons, but why? I mean, I have all the stuff for it, but why? Actually, for that matter, why can't I? Oh, I need two? You need two Titanite Charges to get a plus one. That's different. It used to be just one. Even in two. In Dark Souls 2, it was just one. Okay, Cleric Sacred Chime. I haven't really looked at the stats for this too much. Physical Lightning. Ooh, Lightning is not on here. That's interesting. In Dark Souls 2, your cast power was tied to the Lightning, Dark Fire, or Magic damage of your casting ability. This one, they apparently have a spell... or is it? What is the backbone? Oh, help. See, it was... okay, so yeah, that makes sense. So yeah, in Dark Souls 2 was lightning, dark, fire, magic that determined the attack power thing. So if you gave a chime a lightning enchantment, it would make your miracle stronger. This one, apparently, it just has a specific stat for that purpose. Does that also go... no, it does not go for these, obviously. Unless they had a sword... if they have a spell-casting sword or spear, something like a spear-staff kind of thing, that would make sense. They would have a spell buff on that. Okay, so I haven't really looked at these too much because I don't care about these weapons. I'm not going to use these weapons for very long. I am planning on using a longsword into a claymore because I imagine I will be getting a longsword first because that's usually how it goes. So, reinforce Estus, no Estus shards. We have Estus shards again.
Weapons
Talk.
And protection are sturdy enough by and large, but when overused, they'll eventually break. When their durability is low, repair becomes a necessity. Use a powder, or simply rest at a bonfire. But should chance impel them break, bring them me. I'll hammer them back into shape. They take no pleasure in breaking, I assure you. So handle them with care, if you would.
Will do, Andre.
Hey, be careful. I don't want to see my work squandered.
See, here I thought you were going to tell me to not dare go hollow, but I suppose that's not relevant in this particular game, since hollowing isn't a thing? I'm not really sure how that goes. Seems like ember is a thing now, not hollowing. Not hollow to human, it's... ember to ash, I guess? I mean, I'm embered right now, and I look like I'm on fire, which is kind of neat. there secret things around here? This place is so big, there's gotta be secrets of some kind. I mean, there was Andre, but other than that, there isn't much. Oh, hey, and it's the Crestfallen Warrior. I guess I might as well say hi to him. Because...
another one roused from the sleep of death. Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right. Gives me conniptions. And they'd have us seek the Lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we're talking true legends with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots. Don't you think? What a sick... asking us to seek the Lords at all.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, you're repeating yourself. I don't really care. Of course, Crestfallen Warrior. And hey, there's a person over here right next to Andre, which I totally missed because I went the opposite way.
To make thine acquaintance, Ashen One.
It's a firekeeper.
I am but a humble handmaid of the shrine. Weapons, armor, trinkets, and spells.
She the Emerald Maiden from 2?
Lots of little things to ease the burden of a weary traveler. And yes, I'm undead too. But not so charitable as to give my goods away. Ashen One, fetch souls and bring them to me. As is thy wont, no?
Okay. Seriously, that's clearly one of the old firekeepers. And I feel like that is probably the Emerald Herald, just because the Emerald Herald was kind of one of them. Sort of, but maybe not. She had green robes, not red ones, and the red robes... The Red Robe Club seemed to not really care for her too much.
Ashen One, if my wares are not to thy satisfaction, bring me umbral ash. With ash, I'll fashion new wares. Is it not our sorry fate to sup on death?
To sup on death horribly. Gotta be clear now here what kind of death we're talking about.
Knowest thou of that soppy gossip? That cordial intrusion layeth the path to embers. And so thou art in need of a soapstone, Ashen One.
Ah.
Then thy pockets will overflow with souls to trade to me.
That's true, but thankfully soul memory is not a thing in this game, apparently. I have to check that, actually. I'm not totally sure if soul memory is a I don't think it's a thing.
Ashen One.
I really didn't care for that too much because... well, you... we're basically forced to level up. And hey, white sign soapstone. Well, might as well. Be nice and sunbro-y. Okay, so... heal is... I already got that. Do you have a sword? You have swords! You have a short sword, which is... good enough for now. Oh. Well, I guess I'll have to get some dexterity first. Actually, one thing to point out that's really nice... in Dark Souls 2... these stats were much more extremely skewed, and the requirements were much more extremely skewed. Although it seems that the requirements are still relatively high. They're roughly on par with the way Dark Souls 1 does it, which I felt made the game a lot, and with 3 as well, made and will make the game a lot less dependent on having very specific... oh. So they have talismans and chimes. Interesting. I wonder what the point is of having both talismans and chimes. Are they faster or weaker? I'm just gonna buy that just to have a way of checking. Might as well buy this too, because I am gonna be using it. But yeah, as I was saying, with the stats, because they're closer together when you start out, and they're never any less than 6 or more than 16, you don't have the situation where, and also the stat requirements aren't so skewed, you don't really have a situation where you're basically forced along a few paths or forced to kind of along your class for the first 50 levels or so, which I felt was the case in Dark Souls 2. I might as well get these on. Oops. Get some of these while I'm here. I'm not sure how much I need, but honestly, I don't really care. Oh, 99 is the limit, huh? Interesting. It used to be 999. Really cut down on that. Very Bloodborne-y, because Bloodborne is the same, well, not the same limit, but a lot of things had... 99 limit. Now let's talk to the Emerald or Herald Black Maiden. Her.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I'm a firekeeper.
So is the woman back there. What's your point?
I tend to the flame and tend to thee.
Oh, active firekeeper, I suppose.
The lords have left their thrones and must be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side. Ashen one, to be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls. Sovereignless souls will become thy strength. I will show thee how. Ashen one, bring me souls plucked from their vessels. Ashen one, to be.
Okay, you're repeating yourself, so let's level up.
Then touch the darkness within me. Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls.
It's a bit better than Bearer Seek Seek Less, but not great. Hey, they fixed this! Awesome! I didn't even check this before. Yeah, in one, it wasn't an option to use the mouse at all, which was a bit of a pain in the butt. My curse is not visible. Alright, let's try that now. So yeah, in one, you couldn't do this at all. In two, you could do it, but you had to tap through it first using your arrow keys, and then you could use the mouse. But in three, they fixed it! Granted, they kind of fixed everything about the interface in three compared to two, so yeah, I'm not terribly surprised. Anyway, I want endurance because I always want endurance, and vitality because vitality is good. Actually, I don't need vitality too urgently, but endurance is always something I want, so endurance, actually. Yeah, I don't really care about weapon stats too much right now. But endurance is going to save my butt, so might as well. Because this is a shieldless build, so I need to have rolling.
Farewell,
yeah, the other thing is fixed, which is a little more subtle. Oops, not in equipment, it's in inventory. If I go here and then down, I can go back up without any issue. That used to be an issue. Also, oops, I can't do that there. I need to do that. One thing I do feel like they did break was that you can't go between the different areas easily. Back, and I want to see what happens with the talisman. Okay, it's hard to really tell how much I healed, if anything. Looks about the same speed, cast rate, timing, different graphic. I guess if I want to play like Dark Souls 1, I can use the talisman, but it looks like it's pretty much an aesthetic question. And now I have a sword. Oops. Alright, so this is... Ah. From a very specific angle, I can embed the coiled sword. And create a bonfire. Bonfire lid is putting it a little lightly. I just made a brand new bonfire. Come on, game. Give me some credit here. Alright, cool. Do I have any bone shards? No. And burn is no longer a thing. Burn is just... Well, I guess it exists, but it's no longer that big of a thing. Alright, so... Don't need shields. Don't need this, don't need this. And... yeah. Okay. I have only these two spells. Heal aid isn't really worth it too much to me. And I can immediately travel to the High Wall of Lothric. Well, that's cool. However, I don't care. I'll take that when I get to it. I have other stuff to explore. Like these thrones. I haven't even touched on these thrones. I saw one of them had to get... Ah, there we are. There's the one. One of them has a person in it I can talk to.
All that unkindled, and a seeker of lords. I am Lutleth of Corland. Look not in bewilderment, as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder. If substantiation be thy want, set thine eyes upon my charred corpse. This sad cadaver, no need to be coy. Have a closer look.
Well, if this game had binoculars, I suppose I could, but I'm afraid I can't.
Knowest thou of our purpose? Five thrones will take five lords as kindling for the linking of the fire. The fast-fading flame must be licked to preserve this world. A reenactment of the first linking of the fire. So it is. I became a lord of Cinder. I may be but small, but I will die a colossus.
You are talking to someone who is the spiritual successor, in a way, of two characters who both basically abandoned linking the fire. Well, in one case it was Dark Lord ending, and in the other case it was leave the throne completely and don't even make that option. You're talking to the wrong person, man.
Knowest thou of our purpose? Five.
Oh, well, I don't really care about you. I'm vaguely curious what would happen if I were to kill him, but I feel like I can't and I don't really want to try at this point. I'm guessing it'd be like two where I can hit them a couple times before actually having any problems, but I just don't really want to risk it right now. I guess these must be places where people go to, because, I mean, over time, in Firelink Shrine and Majula in 1 and 2, people came to Firelink Shrine or to Majula over time. So I'm imagining that all those dead ends and small passageways, those are all for people who are going to be here eventually. Just not now. Okay. That's cool. I didn't realize they had writing on the back. Waters of the Abyss. I think we saw them in the intro. You're in the Giant. We definitely saw them in the intro. Couldn't have missed that character. Alright, and this guy is Lugleth the Exiled, which I guess is why he's here. And the Goo Monster. Okay. So we have big guy, many guys, royal guy, small guy, and Goo guy. Apparently I can read the engraving from the other side. Okay. So it looks like I've pretty much exhausted Firelink. I feel like I have. So I found one up here, retracing my steps, found Andre, found the, I'm guessing, retired firekeeper, shopkeeper, found the firekeeper, Mane in Black, Ashen Maiden. Ashen Maiden works. I guess that must be what she can be called. So the Ashen Maiden. Found a bunch of paths. This is one of those paths I think is a total dead end, so not going to worry about it too much. Of course, running into a wall is no good either. And otherwise, actually, one thing before I do go, I do want to check one thing. Yeah, I did. Okay, thank you. Really wish they just had you jump straight to the level up screen when you hit that button. Anyhow, I wanted to see if... Oh, equip load is automatic. No, equip load's shown, but your current equip percentage is not.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Which actually was in 2. So I knew if I wanted to increase my equip load or not, and how much I wanted to increase it by. Alright, well that's a bit of a downgrade, but there were other things where I came in, if I can find my way back. And oh, whoops, that! This is going to be a long climb. No, this is not going to be the most eventful episode. I think that pretty much went without saying, the fact that I'm in Firelink Shrine, and there's a lot of things in Firelink Shrine right off the top. So, this might be a little bit of a less action-oriented episode, though. There's still 10 minutes left. Stuff could happen. Where's the way out? Firelink Shrine isn't a total dead end, is it? There was another path. There's a whole other path. Out this way. Okay, good. We're back to stuff that doesn't involve things that are basically built up for me. Okay, so what I want to know is there a path to Lothric without having to go through the travel option? That was trivial enough. Another ember. Ooh, nice. Okay, so I got two, essentially, humanities. I'm curious how the health system works between being embered and unembered, like basically being human and hollow. Another bone. Nice. Because, I mean, according to the description, there's a health penalty for being dead. Now, I'm not going to throw myself off and die right now. Actually, I'm a bit surprised I don't see a lot of people having done that either. Seems like it's almost a tradition in Dark Souls games to have the one area, like the starting area, people just jump off to their deaths, but I guess it's not quite the starting area, is it? Or the hub area, I mean, the safe area, people just jump off to their deaths for fun, I suppose. I don't know why they do that, but yeah, that's a thing. It's a thing that commonly happens. If you go to Firelink Shrine in Dark Souls 1 and go to Majula, you will see a bloodstain or a pile of bloodstains of people who just threw themselves off the cliff because they wanted to throw themselves off the cliff for, I guess, looking weird because they threw themselves off the cliff. Whoa! Well, I guess we'll find out what it means to be unkindled, or rather, not embered then. Oh, it is a reduction in health, but it's not. Does reduce max health, but it doesn't reduce in an obvious way. It's not, like, in both Demon's Souls and Dark Souls 2, you had a chunk of it not there. Should curse me, I also probably don't want to have the HUD on at all times, but. But yeah, there was a chunk of it that wasn't there. And now it's, oops. Yeah. Like, you'd have the full max health and your hollowed max health. This doesn't show you your full max health, just the current max health, which is a little weird. Yeah, that's all you get. So if I kindle myself, I get a health boost, but it doesn't phrase it like a health penalty. Well, that's interesting. What I wanted to check, because I realized just now the descriptions have some information about what kind of, oh, I see. They have information about what the abilities are. Unfaltering prayer, increased poise of casting miracles, and recovers HP. Oh, okay, so regeneration happens. Hmm. Well, I mean, statistically, I don't know if there's much difference, although I do, granted, have most of them put in. Oh, okay, so chimes scale better, require more faith. Oops. I actually wanted to get the gentle prayer, because why not, or maybe not. I don't know. So, I guess there's was a challenge enemy. Interesting. I'm aware they existed in Demon's Souls. Let's see if I can beat that before we finish this up. Let's see. Go up here. Go up here. Watch the bite. Well, watch the gray phantom go by. And then find the person with my souls who was a bigger pain than I realized they would be. Okay, so they're... Oh, whoa! And they have bleed. Okay, this is gonna be tougher than I had given it credit for. I was trying to go for a backstab. That was a mistake. Going for a backstab is not the best idea in this situation. But I think I'm starting to get the hang of where things are. Oh, whoa, what? Oh. It's not a fog gate, apparently. It's just a waterfall. What the heck? No, wait, this ain't right. What? Was I getting invaded? No, this is the area I was looking at before. Okay, so that's locked. I know. It's not the little orange skin guy. I'll get to that later. Hmm. Okay, whatever. Let's just go back. I mean, that looked like a fog gate. Why would there be a fog gate in Firelink Shrine? Why would there be any invaders? That was bizarre. Okay, that aside, I guess there must be some kind of invasion mechanic or something going on in Firelink Shrine. I don't understand why, but apparently there is, and I don't want to fight you on... Whoa! What?! I can't tell when I'm about to be parried. Oh, I think I heard about this. I think the katana has some kind of counterattack attack. Like, you swing, and then during the attack and the counterattack, you can get hit back? Something like that? I'm not totally sure. Oh, wrong way. No, that was the right way. It's partly the right way. I just missed a turn somewhere. No, I'm going the wrong way. Okay. Up there. Oh, yeah, I did go the wrong way. Turn right, not left. Oops. That'll not be a problem later. I'll figure this place out. It's not too bad. Okay, so I'm kind of wondering if I should be bashing myself against this wall. It's just... I don't know. I feel like I should at least... Okay, that's... I'm barely dealing any damage. Wow, okay. What the? Oh, I got staggered. Getting staggered's no fun. Well, I was closer. I mean, I'm clearly getting the hang of how that enemy works, because it seems like as long as I don't attack when the katana is about, when he's trying to do the Yaddo thing, then I'm fine. Okay, seriously, what? Also, it's fairly obvious that it doesn't... Oh. Weird. Yeah, it's fairly obvious that it doesn't keep reducing health. It only reduces health once. Is that a loading thing? Like, it literally can't load the outside area fast enough? That's weird. Never seen that before in a Souls game. I feel like I shouldn't level up or anything to face this enemy, but at the same time, I don't know if I can. Like, level up the character, not level up myself. Obviously, I gotta level up myself. Seriously, is it just loading times or something? I find this setup very bizarre. Like, why is it forcing me to wait? It's gotta be loading times or something. Like the time it takes to cash in stuff or whatever, but that's already hot cash lines. Why is it doing that? That doesn't make any sense. I don't know, that's weird. Anyway, moving on. So once again with this guy. Oh wait, my souls retrieved were nothing. I ran out of how do you deal with this character? I realize I'm probably not supposed to deal with it until later, but darn it, I beat that crystal lizard. I don't see why I can't beat this enemy. Except for, of course, this silly thing with the fog gates. Oh, wait, right. I have weapon arts, too. Hang on. What are the weapon arts of my current weapon? I should be looking this sort of thing up. What are the weapon arts for this thing? Stance. Normal attack to break a guard, and strong attack to strike upwards. Interesting. Okay, I'm not going to be using the Divine Blessing in combat, so I might as well take that off the list. Oh, tricky. Ah, oh, I was expecting a backstab. Ah, oh, stupid sirloin stuff. Seriously. I feel like I'm getting closer, but I also feel like I'm wasting everyone's time trying this, so I don't know. Try one more time. See what happens. I'm not going to ember up first because I feel like I'm just going to die, but try one more time. Seriously, why is this loading thing happening? Why must you load? And also, why must you mess up my face and not my sword? Oh, it doesn't mess up the sword. Okay, there we go. The only thing I could possibly think of is loading times. Alright, so once again, once more into the annoyance. Oh wait, that's too far away. That was way too close for comfort. What the heck? Ah, I was late in the roll. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to deal with this later, apparently. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, and I realize it's a bit of a disappointing way to end it off. You know, I feel like I'm just going to bash my head against the wall, so let's make at least an illusion of progress and travel the High Wall of Lothric, because apparently that's how it goes now, is that this is essentially a travel hub. This basically is an archstone now. I guess that's how things work. Okay, so I will, Lothric, I guess we'll deal with that other enemy later. But yeah, this is where we'll come off on the next episode. So stay tuned for that. Well, when that comes up. And thanks for watching. Despite the weirdness with that enemy that is clearly, I guess it's like the Red Eye Knights from Demon Souls. I'm kind of not surprised I'm not doing super well against it. I imagine that I'll probably get used to the game enough to the point that I'd be able to deal with it no problem on another level 1 build. But for now, that's not happening. Anyway, thanks for watching and have a good night.